To go in the parents' room. I've never been in a parents' room before, right? You've never been in there. There's like microwaves for warming up milk. There's like change tables. There's lots of comfy sofas, right? If you've ever taken drugs in a nightclub. And it had one of these doors. You push the button and the door automatically kind of opened like that, right? So I pushed the button and the door slides open, and directly facing the door, two women breastfeeding babies. Yeah. What I said next, I think we can all agree, was an error. I said, oh, don't mind me, I'm just having a look.
Have a look at him. Please welcome LLoyd Langford. What the hell happened next?
I ran back to Anne, my partner, and got our child, and then ran back to the parents' room and said, look, I have a child.
Right. I'm allowed to be.
But I was out of breath, and there was nothing about me that suggested it was my child. If anything, the situation exacerbated.
Did they freak out, or they just let you go?
No, it was fine. It was a mix-up, you know. I just kind of...
Well, I ran into your partner, Anne, the other night at a gig. I was chatting to her. How are you guys? You guys doing all right? No, I'm like, how's it all going?
What a question.
It just sounds like Taunton was hitting on Anne.
Lovely lady.
No, it is the dying embers of a neglected fire.
You're in talks.
No, it's going well. We had a bit of an incident recently where she thought I was having an affair.
Really?
Yeah.
Who with?
Well, we've been watching the Beckham documentary.
Oh.
And you know he goes to Spain and he can't speak the language, yeah, and he doesn't have any friends.
Yeah.
And so he had an affair. Well, Anne thought my situation in Australia was exactly the same as that. I was leaving the house on a regular basis, yeah, every Friday morning, and not telling her where I was going.
Oh.
And she ended up secretly following me down the street.
Really?
Yeah. Wow. And I was going to a doctor because I had two warts on my foot.
Why didn't you share that information?
Well, I wanted to fix it before, you know, I thought if I can get rid of it first.
Yeah. There he is, limping off to his new missus again. I'm all over you, LLoyd.
You've lived here for a long time now.
Yes.
So do you find it hard not having your family nearby?
Well, my parents have just been here for 2 months.
Oh.
Yeah. Which is, like, less of a visit and more of a sentence.
Yeah.
They've just gone home.
Oh.
It took them 2 months... just about 2 months to figure out the oven in the Airbnb. My mum would put sausage rolls in at 100 degrees Celsius, and I was like eating it like this just tastes like you've had it in your pocket. Because they have gas mark in the UK. I don't know. I don't understand.
It's always good to slow cook. Party. Give it 7 hours. Now, how's dad life going? How's little Gwenny?
She's good, but we're approaching the milestone on Friday. We're going to start potty learning.
Oh.
Yes.
Yeah. It's not training anymore.
Well,
potty learning.
We're watching this video of these two incredibly annoying, I don't know what you would call them, child poop experts.
Oh, yeah.
And
okay.
they're saying that it's about learning the skill, yeah, that rather than, like, a training regime.
Is that because training sounds like you're training a dog?
I'll be honest with you, when they talk, I do zone out. It's like three hours of toilet training videos that I reckon could probably be cut down to about 25 minutes.
Yeah.
But Anne has about an hour of anecdotes of not making it to the toilet on time. So I'm hoping that genetically Gwen takes after me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because Anne has form.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
As an adult.
Her last show was called Why Is Everything in My Bag Wet? I thought that was about a water bottle.
Your new show, LLoyd, is called Blunt. What's the difference between being blunt and just being rude?
Well, I am going to be rude.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
But
I promise.
Okay.
I'm hoping that because I'm on stage and there's a distance between me and the audience, yeah, that I won't get punched.
Oh. You're gonna be rude to them.
Is that your goal for the comedy? For just not to get punched?
Well, I'm just, you know, when you have everyday kind of interactions and stuff and you think, oh, I wish I said that to that awful person.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Oh.
I'm going to do that for an hour. And I'm sure some of those types of people will be in the crowd, so...
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a moral victory.
It's a moral victory, and also I'll have the microphone stand to...
Yeah. To defend yourself.
To defend myself,
that.
Yeah, against...
The mums from the feeding room, if you can get them back. You'll get it right this time.
Yeah. Well, stay safe, please. LLoyd is taking his new show across the country over the coming months. A link to tickets is on our website. In the meantime, would you please thank the wonderful LLoyd Langford.